furniture store to turn into a car dealer overnight or something? Look at all those cool clouds and mist in the sky flying through the building. No time to capture it right now though, unfortunately. Okay, another super early one tomorrow, it seems like. Well, maybe I get to fly now. Got actually a lot of spare time. Hopefully it doesn't start raining. This was kind of interesting. Basically, it says here in California, in the US, they apparently made this law to, I guess, reinstate the net neutrality for that state only, because apparently before that thing was abolished, like for the country. So I guess as a state, they said, hey, we're gonna introduce this thing back. Basically, the net neutrality is supposed to prevent people like ISPs and stuff from, I guess, being able to dictate what kind of service they can provide for people. Like, for example, what everyone says, they could say, hey, if you want to access YouTube with our service, we'll charge you a premium. Like, that they can't do. It has to be neutral. It has to be like a plain service. So as mentioned, because people assume the worst will happen, basically the state of California said, hey, we're bringing back things like this net neutrality stuff. But the funny thing here, it says Senator Weiner's statement on Trump's administration's lawsuit to strike down Senator Weiner's net neutrality law. So apparently the country is suing the state or something like that. I was like, what? How does that work? Well, I don't really know the who's who in politics and stuff like that. In this guy's tweet, it says, within minutes of our net neutrality bill being signed into law, Jeff Sessions ran into court and sued California, claiming we don't have the power to protect internet access. And then he's like, well, we do. We'll fight you and win, just like we did when you sued us on protecting immigrants. It's gonna be really fascinating to see how this turns out. I don't think I've ever seen anything like that happen in Canada. I know that I've seen two provinces fight over each other, but never a province, I guess, saying, hey, we're gonna make these laws even though we don't agree with the, like, the country as a whole, like what they did federally. It's gonna be interesting. I thought this was kind of an interesting article because it mentions a point that not many people actually talk about. It starts off with the article saying, drones flying into restricted airspace is going to kill somebody, says pilot. From the ground, it can be hard to see the drama taking shape in Canadian skies or the sense of danger that's brewing as traditional aircraft come head to head with drones invading their airspace. They're just in the way and causing a potential hazard that someday is going to kill somebody, said David Cook, who has a unique perspective on aviation and drones. So it says apparently this guy is a retired military pilot, and it says he flew jets for the Royal Canadian Air Force. And this isn't just a pilot per se saying, hey, drones are dangerous, get out of my way, like I'm flying a traditional aircraft. This guy apparently flies a commercial drone business too. Because it says for the last few years, he's been running his own business, Canada, flying commercial drones out of his hometown of Sarnia, Ontario. He's not happy with what he described as an explosion of irresponsible drone use. And he goes on with further points saying, I don't think they're vicious criminals doing this stuff. They're just idiots out there flying around and think they can go anywhere with this flying camera. Of course, they referenced that quote, drone near miss in Quebec that they never even really confirmed yet. They basically stopped investigating it, to my knowledge. But this quote was actually one of the more fascinating ones. It says here, he believes the real danger is pilots overreacting when they see a drone and putting themselves and their passengers in harm's way. And he uses an example here. It says, at Toronto Island Airport, a Porter Airlines Dash 8, I think, made an evasive maneuver that hurt a stewardess, said Cook. Reacting and overreacting actually to something like that is just as much likely to cause damage or hurt somebody or kill somebody or just bring down a plane. That's the point that actually got me thinking, because a lot of people actually mentioned that. It seems like it's such an overreaction. For example, let's just say someone was technically in a controlled zone because he was within a flying zone, like an airport, but he was 4.9 kilometers away and he's like in his own backyard flying, maybe no higher than this tree, okay, or something like that. Is that an overreaction, for example, for a pilot or anybody, a regulator, to say, man, you better not fly in this zone because there's a chance, man, your drone could fly from here all the way up to that airplane, just out of control, crash into it. We just can't take the risk. Or I guess a silly example is, when did you actually brought it up before? At what point does it become something like, say, someone seeing a rat or a spider? Basically, because of that, they freak out. That's it, shut down the whole operation. There's a rat and a spider here, run! Whereas versus like saying, okay, there's a rat and a spider. Is there any danger in the actual situation and context? To me, that's an important point, because actually it says here, it's not clearly exactly what attracts some people to airports and other restricted airspace, but Cook said in the last year or so, he and other pilots have noticed a disturbing number of drone videos on YouTube of planes taking off and landing. Now granted, there are going to be some idiots, like they say, in terms of flying near airplanes. Like, I'm sure there's going to be an idiot like here trying to fly right into the water, here trying to follow like the seaplane like that. I would say it's stupid. But for the most part, why people would want to fly like in a quote restricted airspace is because in a lot of cases, even here, it's ridiculous. Like for myself, even today, there were so many places, like say an open area in a park that's perfectly safe. Just to fly there maybe like what, 60 meters in the air, just to capture some basic air footages of maybe the sun, the sky, and the mountains when it cleared up. But because of things like the restricted airspace, I can't. So in that sense, it's kind of common sense, like why would people want to fly in restricted airspace in that sense? Because for the most part, I don't think there's any danger in those situations for the majority. I mean, that is an extreme example when people want to fly their drones, let's say following like an airplane or right into the airport. Because common sense, I even said it before, most people like myself, we're not idiots. I mean, do you think we want to risk crashing like our $1,000 drone and stuff, causing like a disaster? I don't think so. There's just too much hysteria in that case. Like, when does it become, like I said, that example of, oh no, it's a spider or a rat. But in general, that's an interesting point though, in terms of things like pilot hysteria, just overreacting when they see things like a drone, reporting it, like, is there any real risk? I use the example again, cars pass by me every single day in terms of the sidewalks and stuff, they're quote, really close. Does that warrant me to phone 911 and so forth because of that? Speaking of which, I'm gonna go find somewhere to fly the drone later on too. Early time tomorrow. All right, see you guys later.